Hello, good morning students. Today I am here to present the computer application 9th grade subject session 2. In session 1 we have discussed chapter 3 part 1. Now we are going to discuss part 2. Let's start with our today topic. And today topic is communication and content technology. So let's start with our topic. Content and communication technology. In previous part we have done about guided media. Now we are going to start with unguided media. Unguided media, as the name presents, that is not guided by wired connection. It means in case of unguided media, wireless connection communication will be there. It means a wireless network is called a unguided media. In case of unguided media, your component could be your infrared, Bluetooth, or either it should be your Wi-Fi or WiMAX signal. Today we are going to discuss this first part, that is infrared. It's a binary signal based system. Because computers depend upon binary signal, signal can be transferred by two methods, digital and analog. The signal, when it is transferred in digital form, it is called a binary signal. So your infrared system is a binary signal based system. And maximum two devices can connect. It means its range is very limited. It means one device can be connected with other. No more than two devices can connect on the same network. That is the medium. Now take the example of your cable TV network or your general network. In case of TV, you are having a remote. In front of remote, one glass coating is there. That part is called infrared signal, and that can transfer data up to your cable TV network. It means that can transfer data up to your TV network. Its range is very limited. It uses the infrared light to send the signals. When you are going to start, it can generate the light signal also. It could be of red color light. And when signal is on, its bit value is 1. When signal is off, its bit value is 0. So it is used in a general room, or you can say in a hall. And it cannot cross any wall, it can cross any object. So a line to line communication is present in case of infrared signal. Bluetooth. Bluetooth is the medium that is also used on the concept of wireless communication technology. And in case of Bluetooth, maximum 8 devices can be connected with a network system. Maximum 8 users can transfer data on a same Bluetooth device. It's a very short range covering area. It can be covered maximum up to your full home, or you can say within maximum your building area. And it supports different type of operating systems. Like you are having an Android mobile phone, other one is having an Apple mobile phone, and any other one is having a Nokia mobile phone. All mobile phone is having a different quality of operating system, and it is the network structure that is able to transmit data on different types of operating system networks. And it's a its maximum range is 33 feet. It cannot transfer data more than 33 feet. And the major advantage of your Bluetooth device is very low power consumption is there. If you are using the internet connection, in case of internet connection, when you will measure that, your cell phone battery is going on down very fast. But in case of Bluetooth transmission, it uses a very less power consumption. That's why it's a good device for a limited area. Wi-Fi, the name suggests it's a wireless internet connection in which no wired signal is required. It is required for wide area communication. That is also called as a WAN or WLAN. W presents wide area, and it reduces the network cost because you can transfer a data on a very large network or a group of people. No limit is there how many will be connected. It depends upon the network quality. Wi-Fi could be of different category. Limited user should be there, or more than limited capacity should also be there. It depends upon your network structure. And it is a connection between peer-to-peer network. It means there is no server, there is no any special system required. Each user can directly communicate by giving user ID and password. And a wireless communication is there, so no wire is required to communicate. Now, internet is a collection of networks. It is used to transfer data from one network to another network. It's a collection of interconnected computer networks. It means that are connected with each other. Without internet connection, there is called a network. When this network is working with the help of internet connection, it can transfer data outside your organization. So internet and intranet, both are different things. Intranet can transfer data within an organization. It's a offline network. It cannot transfer data outside the organization. Intranet users are limited, capacity is limited. But in case of internet, capacity is very vast. You can transfer data outside the organization. You need the internet connection also, and you can transfer to any user at any time of any time bound. That is difference between intranet and internet. Now multimedia. Multimedia includes text file, audio file, animation, video files, and the benefit of multimedia software is that it can combine all data together. In same file, text could also be there, audio could also be there, animation also should be there. So it is used to record any file in any format and play using electronic device. It can also pre-recorded and live performance also. It means it's already predefined. Predefined means you can transfer data to any user at any time bound, and it's also used for live performance. Live performance, it means you can do your live discussion on a chat signal also. You can do live performance on a YouTube also. It's a multimedia device and it is used to mix up different type of contents. Now, modalities of multimedia. Multimedia can be used for video teleconferencing, distributed lectures, telemedicine, cooperative work environment, searching in large images and video databases, making multimedia file editable, and voice recognition. Video telecommunication, it's a good medium, and that is generally used in the case of teleconferencing. It means someone is sitting anywhere else and you're sitting anywhere else. You can directly transfer data, the condition is only one, the signal quality should be very good. And distributed lecture, you are going to present live videos, live lectures, you can do with the help of multimedia systems. Telemedicine is also possible. Cooperative working environment, it means you are doing cooperation with anyone, you are providing customer services from your home location, you can also do with the help of teleconferencing. Searching is large images and video databases. And making multimedia file editable, if you want to edit any video or audio file, you can do in the same. And video recognition, you can recognize that which quality video it is, or quality is good or bad. Application of multimedia. Multimedia can be used for different application like creative industries, like in media, or you can say journalism. A different types of, you can say, journalists are there that taking the news, covering the news, or to display the news on their YouTube channels. For that we need the multimedia signals. Second one is commercial. If you want to present your document, if you want to present your product quality, you want to discuss with a group of people, in that case you can also take the audio and video helps. And third one is entertainment purpose. It's a medium for playing the video games also. And fourth one is engineering field. Basically, industrial training are provided in the concept of engineering field, and that is possible online course also, offline course also. So in the field of engineering, ITI can also perform the same method. And education and research for computer-based courses, they are providing online courses, that is education and research part. And scientific research, if someone want to do research, for that he can perform with the help of multimedia, and he can present in front of audience about their research or their reviews with the help of multimedia technology. Components of multimedia. Capturing devices we need, like video cameras, recorder, input device or microphone. Or storage devices we need, hard disk, CD-ROM, DVD. Or communication network like Ethernet, intranet or internet we required. Or display devices like CD quality, dish, speakers, monitors or color printers. These are the components that are required in case of multimedia. One camera is required, storage medium is required, communication network is required, or display device or screen is required. Image files. Image is a collection of pixels that is in a graphics format. So image files can store pictures with different type of file extensions. Like I am keeping abc.jpg, it means a type of jpg extension. If I am writing abc.png, it's a portable network graphics. So different type of image extensions are there, and extension will present which software are required to open that file. Images are editable and opening as per their extension software, and extensions of the file tell the type of required software. And image resolution can be presented in the pixels, how much pixel it is taking on the resolution. And a picture can be contained 3 or 4 color combination. Either it can use RGB. What is RGB? Red, green and blue combination. It's for color pictures. And the fourth color it is cyan, magenta and yellow and black. It could be either 3 color combination or 4 color combination. 2 are standard combination in the case of computer network, computer system. What is codec? Codec is a program that is capable of encoding and decoding the digital data or signals. And codec could be of two types, logic codec and lossless codec. Basically, logic codec generally reduces the quality of your data, and generally it is used to compress your data or reduce your data size. But lossless codec never reduces the quality. It will collect 100% information from your data. It cannot compromise which quality. Your depth, pixel, everything will be as usual. It means the size will be little bit more in the case of lossless codec quality. Now, types of image format. Image format could be of either bitmap, it could be pixmap, GIF, JPEG or PNG. Bitmap image, it's a very, you can say, inferior quality image. It's a type of image storage extension. It uses 1 bit per pixel to store the image, and the picture quality is very bad. And in case of pixmap, it can also use to storage the image, but multiple bits it is taking to store the data. And in case of GIF, GIF is better than bitmap image. GIF presents graphical interchange format. It allows high quality, high graphics to display on graphic hardware, and it can store 8 bits per pixel, and maximum it can support up to 256 color, and its extension is GIF. .gf we can write. And JPG presents Joint Photographic Experts Group. It is used to store grayscale image or gray color image, or you can say full color image, and it can store 24 bit per pixel and 16 million colors combination will be there. So it is much better than GIF and JPG, and the extension of JPG is .jpg or .jpeg. And PNG is portable network graphics. PNG 8 is similar to GIF. It means all features of GIF 8 are in PNG 8, but the difference is it can store data or save data more efficiently. While in PNG 24, it's a lossless compression, and lossless compression presents that we need not to compress the data, so it takes more space to store the file and it provides a best quality pixels. Audio formats could be of three types: uncompressed, lossless and logi. WAV presents window audio video, or you can say window audio format. Or lossless compression, it's a standard window media audio format. And logi compression that will never compromise with your logi compression will compromise your quality, and it will compress the image. So it could be either MP3 or WMA. And video codec could be of 6 category, like H.261, MPG1 part 2, MPG2 part 2, H.263 or MPG part 4, MPG4 part 2, or you can say MPV. First one is H.621. It's a older quality video conferencing, and the video quality is very bad, and user cannot use a good quality picture. And MPG1 is better quality. It can be used generally in video CDs. You can prepare CDs of your audio signal, video signals. And MPG2 part 2, it's for DVD and video broadcasting. You want to broadcast your channel, you want to broadcast your network, you want to broadcast your images, you can use MPG part 2. And H.263, it's a video used in video telephony or internet videos. And MPG4 part 2, it used for broadcasting or your internet services. Basically, for MPG4, we need a good quality network. And MPV, it's for burning CD and DVD on your computer system. Burning presents, you can prepare new CD or copy of CDs. And animation is a method of in which pictures are manipulated to appear as moving images. It is used in video games and PowerPoint presentation. To date, most animations are made with computer generated imagery, and it is used to make your file more attractive. Animation could be either 2D animation or 3D animation, or better than that. But on generally computer system, we are using 2D and 3D animation for different file structures. In this session, we have covered the chapter 3, For any query, you can contact on this contact number. It's also on WhatsApp, or either you can give your comments on sandeep.1291@gmail.com. Please subscribe, like, and share this video for further broadcasting this video, and you can be beneficial from that.